Hi everyone, I'm Trion Thompson and I'm a newly published author. Today I'm going to tell you a bit about my book and the idea behind it. Back in 2009, I was in the middle of making notes on a completely different story about werewolves, and suddenly I got this idea about this girl in back garden. She's surrounded by these three wolves, and two of them attack her, and one of them bites her, but she doesn't know which one. And then suddenly she is flown to a place where she knows absolutely no one, and they all turn out to be werewolves. I don't know how exactly I got the idea, it just suddenly came to me. And that tiny idea has finally grown into this book. Originally the girl had absolutely no name. I had no idea who she was. I didn't know why she was important. Originally she was just randomly bitten. But then the story progressed as I got further into it. These are all the notes and bits I scribbled down when I was first planning the book. And it took me too many attempts to try and get the very first chapter down, which I decided straight from the off that the first chapter had to be the moment where she gets bitten. I went from scribbling chapter one down to printing chapter one down and failing quite easily. And a while after that, I actually had huge meltdown because something major and disastrous happened and I lost all of my work on the computer. Every story idea I had, all gone. Except for the bits that I'd already printed off, or the bits that I'd wrote down in notebooks. So I ended up having to start from scratch again, in a way. Next stage, from after doing chapter one, because chapter one was easy without having to know anything, I started going into characters. The girl didn't have a name yet. It took a while for me to actually get a name. It wasn't until after I'd lost everything that my friend inspired me and I kept on going, and so I named the character after her. But after getting her name, I then went on to finding out who the other's characters are. So there was her family. And then there's obviously the people who she'd been living with. And I knew that this place that she was going to be a huge house. So there'd had to be tons of people there. Especially seeing as it was going to be a werewolf pack she'd be living with. So I started typing up things or scribbling things down. With me, I can't just go in and start writing out kind of things about, oh, what this house looks like. I need to know. I can imagine the outside, simple enough, but the inside is much harder for me, so I created blueprints. So, crappy little scribbled fiber blueprints started out to help me, so I knew where my characters were going, so I didn't keep mixing everything up. All the rooms of the first floor, which was a lot of rooms, second floor, setback. Once the entire book was done and completed, and I knew that it was ready to be published or go to the next step, I have a thing where I have to go back through the entire book, and just in case anything does happen to the copy on the computer, I go through every single chapter and scribble down what happens. Because easier like that. It's just easier to help me if anything does ever happen to my book. Coming up with the title to the book was hard, because originally when I first had the idea and there wasn't a name for my main character, I just called it Once Bitten, because it sounded easy enough. When I then got the protagonist's name, I call it Rhea Holmes, because that's what I usually do with my books. I will, to make sure that I don't mix them up with something else before I have a title, I will name them after their protagonist. So they were called the Rear Hunter books. And then I looked back through ideas in another book, and I saw that I'd named one of them No Longer Human. And I thought, well, that's a good name, and I probably won't use this idea. When in fact I actually do later on in this series. And I said, okay, well, that's a good name for it, so that's my title. And finally, I now have it all printed up, No Longer Human. The series is the No Longer series, and each book will be No Longer Whatever. To get you more interested and to let you know a bit more about the book, I'm going to read you Blur, in other words, back cover. One moment can change your life forever. That's basically the tagline for the entire series. When 16-year-old Rhea Holmes is bitten by what appears to be a wolf, her human body is dragged through hell and back as she goes through transition. She finds herself in a strange home with even stranger residents. Lycanthropes, shapeshifters and vampires, once these things were nightmares, now they are reality, and on the next full moon, Rhea will become one. Being a teenager is hard enough. Now she must deal with the heat of the moon, a bloodthirsty nature, and a murderous werewolf who is hell-bent on obtaining her. And then at the bottom, it says, coming soon, No Longer Contained, which is the next book, and I don't know when it's coming. Hence. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you like werewolves and vampires and shapeshifters, if you like Supernatural or Buffy the Vampire Slayer, then you will like this book. If you want to hear more about my book, stuff related to it, my other books to come, then you can subscribe to this channel. There will be links in the description to my other websites like Twitter and so on. There will also be links in the description as to where you can buy the book if you are interested. In the UK you can get hold of this. If you're going to go to Waterstones, you may have to ask them to order it in, because it's a self-published book. America, I'm not too sure, unless you can order it from Ukrainian Amazon, which will be in the description. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I will probably do a Q&A on them. In my next video on this channel, I will be reading the little preface and possibly the first chapter, One Human Moment. I will also be talking about the world of my No Longer series, in particular on the werewolf concept.